Alrighty.
Alrighty. Alrighty then.
Okay. Come on. Alright.
Every little thing she does is magic. 1981's Ghost in the Machine. Now this one's hard for me to do. Because I haven't really played with live bands for a long time. I don't have a lot of stamina. Okay, this is like 4 minutes and 20 seconds of Stuart Copeland, right Handberg. Now, to younger dudes these days, it's not fast at all. They'll be like, but I'm telling you, I seem to these days run out of gas. But let's see how it goes. And if you look at the link below, you'll see a link to somebody posted, Sting made demos for these songs on Ghost in the Machine that they just brought in to the studio and just overlaid Andy Summers and Stuart Copeland's parts on. And that's what you get. And this song being the grandpappy example. All right, roll tape. So I can't give you the, because that's the cue to come in. Does that make any sense? Well, let's just do this. Hang on, all right, bear with me. Pull my underwear up, roll tape, break a leg. Here we go. Sorry. We did that one last time. Get that! Okay, we want to do this. No! Am I 47 or what? How do you program the VCR, son? All right, now we're almost there. Maybe I'll switch sticks. No, we'll keep that one. All right, ready? Roll tape. Come on, baby. This is a... You're kidding, right? Okay. Sorry.
We'll be right back.
Sorry. Woo!
Now, I gotta tell you, that's hard for me to play these days. You know why? Because I'm getting old. And it's hard for me to play 4 minutes and 20 seconds of oi of eighth notes all over the joint. So hopefully that was up to par. A stick did break, which always seems to happen sometimes. I almost never break them. But anyway, hang on. Let's talk a little about Ghost and the...
Let's talk a little about Ghost and the Machine. Hi there. I'm Ken Nardine. So, Ghost and the Machine, 1981. So they're in Montserrat, right? And they recorded it. So Sting went down there and brought all these demos that he made at a studio. These weren't things he whipped up in his bedroom. But what he did was so they essentially went down there, and if you can go on YouTube and look in the link below here, I'll put a link to the demo he did for Every Little Thing. And you can pretty much hear everything's the same. You might have added a couple like vocal harmonies, changed a couple little things up. Copeland definitely just threw his drums over the top. And they added some of the guitar part, like jig, 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 that part. It's really neat. So I'm a big Police Stuart Copeland fan. And I had to throw this one out there. I might redo it, though, because, I mean, it's really hard for me to play this one. About 4/5 of the way through it, I just run out of gas in my right arm. I just can't play all those notes. So hopefully that was a reasonable facsimile thereof. I did used to be able to play the song all the way through with great ease back in the day. Thanks for putting up with my drum covers. I'm going through a drum cover phase. I'm just addicted to doing drum covers. So more stuff on the way. A lot of Zeppelin coming up. I got to get a lot of Zeppelin out. Remember, I can't do a lot of Zeppelin tunes because it's not approved by the Warner Brothers Led Zeppelin Council of America. But the ones I can do, I will do. Okay? So more videos coming up.
Boy, I really love this microphone. Hi there.
Anyway, again, thanks for watching. More videos on the way. I have to get up and manually turn the camera off because I cannot edit this in YouTube, which is my only editing platform. So bear in mind, hang on. I'm going to kill this so I can adjust it and it won't kill your ears. Hang on. Be patient. You can watch some behind-the-scenes stuff in action.